Greetings, Southwest Local Schools parents and guardians. John Hamstra, superintendent, here to give you a first semester of 2022 update. Like every school year, we're experiencing some tailwinds and headwinds. First, the good. Our mission is being lived out, academic and social growth for all students every day. Our staff's been working diligently with our kids to rebound academically from the pandemic, and our efforts are really starting to show in the data from the fall of 2021 to fall of 2022. We still definitely have some work to do, but our intervention efforts and instructional strategies, especially the Orton-Gillingham training in grades K through 12, is really showing. Our next academic benchmark, our winter assessments, will take place in January. And then building and grade level teams will meet with administration to analyze that data and prepare the different interventions and enrichment to finish up the spring. A reminder, our goal is to grow all kids 1.5 years academically each and every year in each subject area. At the high school, where career readiness is a major focus, we've had over 1,000 industry recognized credentials earned by our students as of November 30th. We also had 9 graduates this winter, which is a new record. Hundreds of our students are participating in work-based learning internships and pre-apprenticeship programs, and the new entrepreneurship courses at the junior high and high school are off to great starts. Speaking of passion, another goal this school year is to have 100% of our kids involved in at least one extracurricular activity. After first quarter, we had 79% of our students involved, and as of second quarter, we're at 84%. In that quest to get to 100% of our kids. Our elementaries have added numerous clubs for students to get involved in, from karate to baton and dance, juggling, life skills, chess, theater, computer science, yoga, esports, girls on the run, and elementary chorus. Please press on your students to get involved. If sports are your thing, we are really looking for our kids to play 3 sports during the school year. We've had so many wonderful stories coming from both parents and kids trying new sports out, whether that be swimming for the first time, cross country for the first time, bowling, tennis. We've got kids jumping into these non-cut events and sports and doing very, very well. So please push on your kid to get involved. Another tailwind that's really rounding out the social growth side is our mission to get kids involved in community service. And we've had a lot of opportunities from Operation Christmas Child to STEM Goes Red to our Veterans Day assemblies to the Mayor's Fund Food and Clothing Drive, where we raised over 30,000 canned goods as a district to help those near. Now some headwinds or challenges that we're encountering as of late. As we've mentioned throughout the year, enrollment is something we're keeping a very close eye on. As of December 1st, we had 502 students attending here at Southwest. 46 kids, or plus 46 kids over last year at this time. 37 of those 46 are at Crosby Elementary. Our largest graduating class currently is our first graders that have 401 students, and our smallest is actually our seniors that will be graduating this May at 274. Bottom line is Crosby is packed to the gills. When we passed the levy to build 3 new elementary schools and the new junior high over 5 years ago in November of 2017, we partnered with the state of Ohio for 34 cents on a dollar, or nearly $27 million in total. Their projections, not our school districts, dictated the square footage necessary for the new buildings. Obviously, development to the north is booming and thus filling out Crosby much quicker than the state was projecting. That said, in addition, eventually at Crosby is going to be necessary anywhere from 4 to 8 classrooms. The good news is all of our new buildings were built to hold additions in the future for when and if that became necessary. And enrollment growth is a good thing as long as we handle it properly. Miami Whitewater, Harrison Elementary, and the junior high, their enrollments are staying pretty flat, which is good news. But we will start to see at the high school a space crunch as these groups of 274, like our seniors right now, get replaced by 350, 380, and eventually 400 students in a graduating class. Tailwind number 2 is mental health, and we're working aggressively right now to meet the extensive mental health needs and struggles that are prevalent in our schools today. We've brought in Best Point, formerly Children's Home, to help provide some services for students and families. The demand and the need for services is currently doubling the supply of therapists that we have in our schools. And this is really straining our buildings at the building level, straining our staff. The same is true all over the Cincinnati area. One positive on this is the local churches and this city, his city, stepping up to partner with our schools to help alleviate this challenge. We're working on a sustainable way to tackle the mental health crisis in our area by teaming up with as many outside groups and resources as possible. Tailwind number three, staffing and illness. There's always a great deal of illness this time of school year, impacting both our kids and staff. Several districts in the area have actually had to close due to staffing shortages brought on by illness and folks being out sick. Fortunately, we have not had to resort to closing, but we have limped along in several spots to get to the end of the quarter. I appreciate our staff jumping in to sub and cover one another when they're out sick. Teamwork is definitely making the dream work happen this winter. Ending on a positive, this past spring, summer, and fall, we surveyed the community and assembled a team to create our next 5 to 10 year strategic plan. Over 1,100 community members responded to the survey, and speaking to what's going well with our schools, what they viewed as our challenges, and what they would like to see as our priorities and focus moving forward. The top four goals that came out of this plan are, number one, academic and instructional excellence. Number two, financial stewardship and sustainability. Number three, student and staff wellness. And last but not least, next level facilities. We plan to continue with our strategic plan and goals this winter and spring with an intensive community engagement effort that will be comprised of another broader survey and 5 face-to-face town hall meetings that will focus on fleshing out these goals and the focus of our schools moving forward. Here's to an awesome holiday season for you and yours. Have a great Christmas and Happy New Year. Stay safe, stay healthy, and go Cats.